So that's a little bit of a mat in this photo. Hello, okay. Trying to figure out how to use my iPhone this time, guys. Oh, you can see all this, so that's good. Cool, so just waiting for everyone to come on and we'll start barre class today. Because guess what? I get to fill in again. Fun stuff. Cool.
It's the same.
We'll get started in a little bit. Oh, good morning, Dorota. I got my matching green chair and my green mat. Got like 5 minutes. Let's start then. We just need little weights if you got them, a chair if you can, right, or the edge of your couch. And just make sure we got some room to move those arms and maybe to lift those legs, because we will throw in some kicks since it's center bar class today. Let's see how we do after 2 months of not doing it, right? That's where my head's at. Little weights in a chair if you've got it. Showed my bum. I'm sorry. Move my mat. I don't want to hit my roots. All right, guys, I'm just gonna quickly see if I can change up my music since it's Facebook is saying I'm copywriting and I gotta fix something. Alright. I hope you guys can hear me. And let's just double check that music issue. Can you guys all hear me okay? Just give me a little thumbs up or something, letting me know you can hear me so that they don't mute me again now that I changed tracks. Because I want to get sweating. All right, so let's grab our little dumbbells and let's start standing. Let's bring those legs nice and wide Hands at our side. I need light. Light. There we go. Now you can see me. There we go. Shoulders up and back. Four, three, two. Good. Big breath. Nice and high. Inhale. Nod the chin. Look down. And again, inhale. And nod that chin. Up, let's take it into those ribs. Inhale. Round those ribs. Stretch it between the shoulders. Take it into your waistline. And again, down into your waistline. Soften those knees. Good. And again. Good. All the way down to those ankles. And again, let's do a little bit faster. Down and up, all the way down, all the way up. Four more. Four, three, and two. Last one, hold it here. Stretch those hamstrings, lift your bum as high as you can, bend, stretch. Down and up. You got it, down. Lighten up the back of those legs. Breathe. Three, two, one. Good. Rolling it up, stacking the spine. Right hand up and over. Pulse. Reach. Eight, seven, six. Get right up into those obliques. Four, three, two. Hold. Soften the knees. Roll it down to the floor. Roll it up to standing. Other side, left hand over top, pulse, right into that left oblique. Breathe, six, five, three, hold, and roll it around, and up, nice and smooth, over, and roll it down. Try to make this circle bigger each time you go, really finding a stretch in the low back, right at the top of your pelvis. Go one more each side. And then we're gonna hold that stretch, right hand over top. Hold it here. Seven, six, five, four, three, two. Drop it down to your ankle. Put the dumbbells down, grab that leg. Bend the right, up, down, up. So pulling away from the hands, away from the foot you're looking at. Hold it down. Take the left hand, that back arm high, spiraling into your thigh. All right, bring it down. Let's rotate, pivot to that left wall, high runner's lunge. And you're just gonna push front and back off that back foot. Push, 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 and push for four. And three, and two, one. Good. Lift your bum, back leg in. Bending both legs and stretching. If the floor is too far, squeeze the inside or the outside, the joint of your knee, to help support that joint as you find your balance. Two more. Last one. Good. From here, grab those dumbbells, come back to center, and roll it up. Good, we're gonna do the other side. Take it over, hold. Three, two, bring it down. Grab your ankle, pull away. Pull away. Good, keep breathing. Good, four, three, two, hold it down. Right hand, back arm high. Keep the weight in that left foot, left heel. Good. Bring it down, pivot for your high runner's lunge. Good. Little pulses, front and back. Just warming ourselves up before we get into our balance and our more center bar stuff. Good, we're lifting our bum up, back leg in. Make that triangle with your legs, down and up. Again, hold that knee if you need to. or your thigh if the floor is too low. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. You're gonna grab those dumbbells, come back to the front, roll it up. Couple shoulder rolls, what you guys saying? Morning. Happy Mother's Day for any moms that are joining us this morning. Good, step touch, left and right. Good, you got lots of time, so let's make it bigger. I changed my playlist this morning because Facebook was gonna mute it because it was popular songs by the original artist. So we got this Latin mix going on. Hopefully they don't mute me. But that means I'm not sure what songs are coming, so we get to have fun with that this morning. Plus, Latin music makes me think of the beach, the resort, so I need a little cocktail. And somehow it's cold in Toronto and in Brighton again today, so wherever we are, let's just pretend we're warm. I'm gonna make you warm, but let's pretend we're someplace warm. 4, 3, 2, 1, keep it wide. Pull those arms back. I want you to stretch out those ankles, tap those toes. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now step touch, right leg, bring it in for me, and only the right. And in, and in, and in. Let those arms swing to pull, lifting the knee up. So knee up, knee up, knee up. Now take a punch, punch forward, punch forward, punch forward. 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, back to the tap, same side, tap, and tap, and tap, and tap. 4, 3, 2, change sides, let's go, left leg in, tap it in, pull those arms, in, breathe, good, knee high, punch, knee up, punch that right arm out, lift, breathe out. 4, 3, 2, back to the tap. Put that foot in. Foot in. 4, 3, step touch side to side. Going in. In. You got it. 4, 3, 2. Go, keep it wide. Tap those toes. Go. We're going to get into that side glute here. Work a little more balance. So let's bring those hands in. Just push those dumbbells together. Clasp your hands together in front of the chest. For 4, 3, 2, stay on your left foot. Right leg goes up, down, up. Slow it down. Nice big deep breath. Slow down that heart rate a little bit. Find your control. 4, 3, 2, one. Now pull that right foot back off your mat behind you. Same thing. Lift it up. Reach for the back wall. Back corner of that wall behind you. Zip up that belly. Good. Try to lengthen up and out of your waistline so you're not compressing the low back. Good. I want you to alternate. One more. Here we go. To the side. Lift it. Adjust. Pull it back. Adjust. Side lift. Adjust and back, side, up, side, back, side, lift, pull it back, lift. 2 times, one each side. Here we go, last one each spot. And we're gonna change sides. Shift it over, straight out to the side. Left leg up, 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 up. Good, soften that standing leg. Feel that weight in that heel. Cross your big toe, baby toe. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, adjust it. Pull it back behind your mat. Back wall, down, up, and up, up. Breathe, lift, lift, lift. You got it. 4, 3, 2, now we alternate, bring it forward, lift it side, pull it back, lift, bring it side up, back up, side lift. That standing leg is getting tired, right? That's why your left leg is fatiguing faster here. Lift, 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 Keep breathing. We got two more on each position. So that's two. Two. One. One. Bring it in. Woo. Good. Stand feet parallel. Big breath high. And roll it down. I hope that was the song. Good. Soften those knees. Roll it up. Nice. We can put those dumbbells down. We're going to grab our chair. Grab a drink of water if you need it. What is it saying? Phone is saying something to me. Okay, cool. Grabbing our chair. So, in class, I like to take that bar and put it in front. So, by all means, you are welcome to put your chair in front. If I do that, you can't see what I'm doing. Okay? So, my chair is going to go beside me. Okay? But not wobbling, hopefully. So, parallel feet, hands on your hips to wake up the feet. I want you to bend your knees, lift your heels, stretch, lower. Bend, pop those heels, stretch, lower. Working up, working through those feet, those ankles. Four. Three. Two. One more. Good, now reverse it, go up, bend, heels flat, stretch, up, bend, heels. Now push through those heels to squeeze your glutes as you come up. So you rise, you bend, your heels go down, squeeze right up into those sit bones. Two, last time, up and bend, heels, good. Now rise, up and bend your knees. Pause. We're going to open those legs. Out, 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 out. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it. Stretch. Bring them back to parallel down. Good. Up and lower. Just those calves. Nice and slow. Take your time. Four, three. I'm going to make it even slower. We got two counts to go up, so we're going halfway, all the way, halfway, down. Halfway, all the way, halfway, down. Up, up, lower, lower. Notice if it's all in one foot, try to space it out. I'm really using my right, so I gotta think more of my left. Good, single time, up and down. Goes up, and up, up, and up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, rest. Ooh. Good, now we're gonna do the same thing, rolling through the ankles with our feet in turnout. So let's just find that rotation from the hips, heels together, knees and toes open, coming right from the top of the pelvis, top of the legs, okay? So we plie, we stretch and down. Plie, ankles, stretch the legs. I wanna see those kneecaps being pulled up your quads. Down, up, stretch, lower, down, up, stretch, lower. Four, three, two, one. Good, now reverse it. Rise up, try to glue those legs, bend them. Heels together, stretch. Glue your legs for as long as possible. Up. Challenge if you want it, don't use your chair. Right, both hands on those hips. Keep that tailbone pointing down right underneath your rib cage. Good, last one. Good, now rise it up to bend the knees. Hold it there, and we pulse it going down. Down, little pulses. Whoo! My ankles are like, what are you doing, Dana? Good, breathe up. Sit, pubic bone to sternum. Pulse. Okay, nothing wrong with the chair. Four, three, two, one. Stretch it up and down. Nice. We're gonna take the chair to our side and grab one dumbbell. So let's put the chair on our left hand. And I want you to find your grand plie, so that nice wide position, okay? So fingertips are reaching for the chair. Don't be tight to the chair. Stretch it out. Okay, legs turned out. We're gonna lower and lift. We're trying to get as low as we can, bringing those thighs parallel to the floor, placing weight into your heels, the outside of your baby toe. Take that right arm out, in, out. So lateral raise, arm is moving up to second position. Two, hold it, take your right heel, pop it up, turn your palm up. You're gonna bicep curl. So I want you to stretch and curl that right hand in. Keep that right heel lifted off the ground. Breathe out and out and out for four, three, two, one. A half lie, there you go, bring it back down. Now add a side bend, both feet flat. Arm to second, over your head to the side. Reach into that side, left wall. And reach. And reach. Good, four. Three more. And two. Now, we're gonna do the same thing, but push. So transfer your weight, come back to second. Push off that right foot. So you're gonna bring your body and your elbow close together on that left side, over, and over. Three, two more. Now hold it over for that oblique. Pull your right leg and elbow in, and in, and in. You got it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, bring it back to second, and up. Good, changing sides. So, swap the chair to the other side, bring your dumbbell to the other arm. Now I gotta remember it, right? Plies, down and up. Down and up, find your footing, find that rotation from the hip socket, add that left arm, out, and out. Breathe, and reach. Reach. So we have four more here. Four, three, two. Good. Now pop that left foot, bicep curl. Stretch it up. Stretch it up. Keep that elbow high. Don't let that arm fall. Lift. Feet, straight arm over, stretch it over and down. Reach over, flat feet so you press through those heels, squeeze those glutes at the top. Use that oblique to reach over. Four, three, two. Get ready because we're going to transfer our weight. Last time. Now push everything onto the right and back. Onto your right and back. Over. Keep that rotation. Don't lose it in that left leg. Keep it turned out. For four. And three. Two. One. Half lie. Do one more. Stay over. Stay up. Stay up. Elbow, knee. Up. Up. Breathe. Try to keep lifting that chest nice and high. Feel the crown of your head reaching up to the top of the wall, to the ceiling. Almost. Four, three, two, one more. Bring it down. Second, and up. Woo. Good, drop the dumbbell. I'm gonna turn sideways so you can see the chairs in front of you, okay? Your favorite, we're gonna do that glute series, that kick to the back. So let's find our turnout. Again, everything can be done in parallel if need be. Okay, so parallel just means that when you bend, your foot goes to the sky. But if we're bent, we're in that attitude position. Okay, so we're turned out. I'll start with my left since it's the one you guys can see. So get a little closer to your chair. Brush that leg back. Nice little attitude swing. So it's a soft knee reaching to your side wall. out. Pay attention to how high your chair is, right? It's not quite the same as that bar we have at the studio. For four, three, two, because we're going to tip forward. So use your arms to resist the tip forward so that you don't just collapse into your chair. Your foot will go higher. It's the same swing. Attitude swing. Take it up. Take it up. Good. Four. Three. Two. We gotta hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Bending both legs more. Stretching. Bending. Stretching. Watch. Notice how I'm opening up to you. I don't want to. I want to keep it down. Keep yourself square to the floor. Keep it square to the ground. Four. Three. Two. One. We're gonna keep it bent. And then take that left knee higher, higher. Think of a clamshell from Pilates. Rotate that leg open, 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 open. Four, three, one. Hold it. Whole leg goes higher. Clean the back wall with your shin, right? With the top of your foot. Lift, lift. We gotta work on those deadlifts almost. Four, three, two. Hold the leg, hold it, hold it, squeeze that left bum. Now think right bum cheek, stand tall. Take it over. Challenge is to take your hands up. Hands will catch you, and then squeeze your right bum cheek. So it is your right leg bringing you back to vertical. Lift. Four. Woo. Three. Two. One more time. Oh, shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out. Good, grab a little drink of water. I need it, I'm talking. Okay, we're going to the other leg. Morning, morning. All right, other leg. Same setup, bum under. Right leg swings. Back, back. Nice and tall. Try not to tip forward yet. Stay up tall. Your bum will get in the way. That's what we want. Feel your bum cheek in the way, resisting how high that leg lifts. Four. Two. Now we tip it over, use your arms so that you don't just collapse into your chair. Lift, the leg goes higher naturally. Don't try to reach my height, but naturally it goes higher because you're tipping forward. Yeah, you don't have your lower back stopping the movement. We're opening up the hip more. Three, two, tip over, stay. Good. From here, we bend it in, we stretch it. In, stretch it. Square up your body. Try to bring the right side, right rib cage, right hips facing the ground. Breathe. You got this for four. Anyone else realizing it's been over 2 months since we've done this? I am. Good, let's hold it. Take that knee, open, open. Find more rotation. You got it. I didn't realize I cut my head off, sorry guys. Legs more important. Four, three, two, hold it, whole leg higher. Higher, 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 higher. Breathe, you can do it. Feel your bum cheeks. Good, hold the leg, squeeze that right. Use the left, up and over. And up. Good. Hands coming off the chair. Gives you a little bit more challenge. Right? You gotta keep that rotation in the left leg. You gotta use your glutes, your abs to fight for your balance so you don't fall over. Three. Two more. One more time. Woo! Shake it out. Shake it, shake it. Good. Get rid of your chair. Nice. Good. Let's come down to the ground. So, down here on the ground, I think I need to angle just a little bit so you can see more of my arms and my legs. We'll see what we got here. Okay, so let's do one dumbbell. Okay, let's find four-point kneeling. So hands underneath your shoulders, knees under your hips. And we're gonna take this right leg straight back, left arm forward, and they're just gonna lift straight up and down. Start with a simple bird dog. Lift, lift. Keep pushing the floor away. Try not to sink. into your right supporting arm, but lift high. Feel your back, the back of your head, back of your bum touching the ceiling. 4, 3, 2, 1. I want you to hold everything up. Take the left arm all the way around. Hamstring curl. In, extend. Bend the elbow, bend the knee. Squeeze that tricep. Squeeze it. For 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it down. We're gonna change sides. Good, because this is all we're doing with the weight while we're here on all fours, so let's just get it out of the way. Right arm is forward, left leg back. We're gonna lift them up, down. Go it again, no sinking. Yeah, keep pushing up away from the floor. Eyes are on the ground in front of your fingertips. 3, 2, hold it, right arm all the way back. Good, bend the elbow and the knee, extend, bend, reach, 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 you got it. Draw that waistline up on that exhale. 4, 3, 2, one more, good, bring it in, good, dumbbell down, good. So instead of our wrists, let's come down to those forearms. By all means, if you feel better on straight arms, stay there, okay? But this is to give your wrists a break. It's also to work your core a little bit in a different way because now we're tipped, right? Our head is gonna be lower than our bum. I wanna go back to our first leg, so that right leg. Take it back, straight up, straight down. Let's point that foot if we can. If not, flex it, okay? I want you to feel the energy behind the back of your knee regardless. I want to feel your quadriceps engaged. Lift. Breathe. Try not to lean into your left. Try to keep your weight equal across both arms. 4, 3, 2. Hold it high. Now pull it down to the left side of your mat. Up and out to the right side. Up and into the left. Up and out to the right. Again, if it's pointed, keep it pointed. If it's flexed, keep it flexed if you can. Draw that waistline in and up. This is all for that right bum. It's also for your transverse abdominal muscles. Right? They help keep your pelvis stable, level. 2. Last time out to the right. Bring it back to center. Bend your knee. So now I want you to flex your foot. Pull it down behind your left knee and up. So cross it in, lift it straight up. Don't open it, just lift it straight up, cross it under, straight up, cross it under, straight up, and lift, you got it. 8, roll your shoulders back, open that chest. 5, 4, 3, I am so happy I didn't shower yet this morning, I'm dripping on my mat. 2, I need to add one, that's okay, hold it up. Little pulse is going higher. Think of popping a ceiling tile, right? Raise the roof with your heel. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Take a moment. Oh, there's my bum. I woke up this morning going, I can feel my bum and hamstrings. I don't know if it was from one of my classes or one of Dora's classes, but I feel it, and we're gonna feel it again. So, bring it back, other side. Roll those shoulders back, push yourself away, left leg long, straight up and down. Lift, and lift, you got it. Up, and up, breathe. Good, draw that waistline in and up. 4, 3, 2, hold it, cross it into the right side, up and out to the left, into the right, out to the left. So you're drawing a nice big arch. Think of the Dufferin gate, right? Lift up and over, draw it with your toe on the wall behind you. Try to pull your ribs in. Don't let them flare open if we can. Think of those ribs knitting together on that exhale as that belly pulls in higher. Four more. Three more. Two more. Ooh, it's burning. We still got halfway to go. Lift it back up. Bend the foot. Cross it in and up. Cross it behind that right. Now I'm sinking in my right hip, so I gotta lift myself up and off of it. Square my hips back to my mat. Imagine I still had my left leg on the ground, right, to help me balance. Four. Three more. Whew, gotta do a good bum stretch after this, I think, right? Three-handed class. Hold it high. Pulses higher and higher. Lifting and lifting. Keep breathing. Eight, seven, no leaning. Five, four, three, two, one. Bring it down. Oh, good. Lovely. Good. We're going to come back to the hands just for a moment. Let's just do a cat-cow, kind of loosen anything up. Scoop the belly and extend it out. Scoop. Extend. Scoop. Extend. Last two. One more. Good. Very nice. We're going to come down onto our bum. I want you to grab your little weights. Now, if we were in the studio, we'd have a little squishy ball. Okay? So we can do this without the ball. Just means you won't go as deep, and you really got to focus on your low abs. If you need to, use a little pillow for support. And I really just want you to squish it under your bum, kind of like a door stopper. So get it in there. Grab those dumbbells. And then we're going to sink into it, okay? But if it's a squishy pillow, this one's not so squishy, okay? Make sure you got a little support. Otherwise, we're going to work without it. Somebody's saying something to me. Morning, Maury. That's okay. You can do it back later, Caroline. Okay. So as I said, let's sit up. Have our knees bent. Comfortable. Don't squish them in. Comfortable position. Dumbbells in our hands. Just scoop your spine. Belly button, pull it back. Lengthen and lift. Scoop. Feel your hip bones pulling away from your thighs. Scoop. And lift. Scoop. And lift. And scoop. And lift. Scoop. And lift. Now scoop and hold. Okay, press into your heels. Keep scooping your belly. Go an extra couple inches so your hands are higher. Lift them above your knees. Bicep curls. In. Breathe out. Focus on your low abdominals here, not so much the bicep curls, okay? Our weights aren't super heavy. You just gotta keep your elbows high. But focus on that belly, pulling backward, right, into your spine, hip bones, belt loops, if you will, on your pants, pulling away from your thighs. So you're trying to open up or lengthen the hip flexor. That's why I want you to push down with those feet. Four more. Three. Two. One, we're gonna do a little rhomboid, but we're gonna do 90 degrees today. Sit tall and open, scoop back and close. Exhale, lift, inhale. Lift. Lift. You can breathe the other way too. Okay, I'm not particular today, but pick a position. Make sure that you can scoop that belly. So you might need to exhale on the way back. Inhale, lift high, that might work better. Okay, it's a little more advanced to round the belly. And breathe in, just because I want to make sure you keep your core engaged. Three more. Two. One more. Go ahead, bring it back in. Take a moment. Ooh, if you need to drop your legs out, do that. All right, I know those hip flexors want to kick on, so let's just do a little release of them, because I want to do another exercise here. All right, more work for your lats and for your serratus muscles, right? Lower trap. So bring yourself back. Same position. Scoop your belly. Hands are back over your knees. Palms facing in. One hand over the head and back. Exhale. Good. Alternating. I'm going to have to change that song. Just keep it going. Both hands are going to go up over your head if you can. Both up. Pull your belly in. Don't let it push into your shirt. Pull it away. Pull it away. Four more. You got this. Three more. Two more. Last one. And bring it in rest. Whew. Good. We're going to take it down to the ground. Move so I don't hit the other couch in here. Okay, on our backs. Good. Let's just go into some bridge work. So feet in line with your sit bones, hands down on the floor. I just want you to articulate, peel your pelvis up, and roll it all the way back and down. Let's push down through those big toes so you keep the inner thighs engaged. Good, exhale, peel and lift. And roll it down. Two more times. And down. One more. Hold it. Good. From here, right leg up. Good. Lower your bum and lift it. Lower and lift it. Lower. Use those arms. Press down. Eight. Single leg bridge. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One more. Good. Change legs. You're up high. Lift it, lift it. Other leg. Lower down. Lift. Down. Up. You got it. Open up your chest. All right. Collarbone wide. Soften those ribs. Eight. Seven. Five. Four more. Three. Two. One, hold it, both feet down, and roll your spine down. Whew. Good stuff. Let's pull the right leg in, left leg long. Move it from side to side, just give it a little loosening. Right, you're gonna circle the leg and the hip. Good, let's change legs. Grab the left, right leg long. Move the left leg side to side. Circle it in the hip. Circle in the other direction. Good. We're going to go into some lower ab work. So again, in class, I take the ball and put it underneath your bum. You've got a yoga block. You've got a squishier pillow. You can put the pillow there. But make sure that it doesn't tuck your bum. Okay? I still want to make sure that you get your tailbone down and feel that length from your ribs to your hips. So the suspenders are tight. But stretched, okay? If you don't have the pillow, don't worry about it. Those are options. More challenging to feel your back into the mat, okay? So let's bend in tabletop. Toe touches to start. Feel this belly pull in. Exhale. Okay, this is a simple version to make sure you can connect your breath and your abdominals. That's what I want you to focus on, breath and abdominals here. Thigh is being pushed away from you, right? Push it away. The farther it goes, the more challenging it's going to be. Good. Four more. Three. Two. One more. Good. Now glue your legs together. Arms to the side. We're going to rotate. Take your legs to your left. Halfway. Exhale, bring it back to center. Inhale to the other side. Exhale, center. You got it. Inhale. And exhale. I find this one to be a little gift. Sometimes I get a nice adjustment right through my spinal column. If you do, bonus, right? You can't see your chiropractors. You just fixed yourself. Pull that waistline in. Again, make sure your belly is always pulling in and away from your shirt. Away from the waistline of your pants. Last one each side. Good, bring it back. Good, from here, let's go straight legs, a variation of our scissors, okay? Your hands will come back to support you. Right leg is gonna lower to the ground. Press it a little bigger, and then up. So you're gonna go down, down, up, alternating. Right leg down, exhale, lift. Left leg, exhale, exhale, lift. Exhale, again, if that top leg needs to bend, that's okay, but stretch it as much as you got. Stretch it as much as you can. Breathe. Feel your lower back sinking into the mat, right? If we're flat on the floor, I want you to feel that lower back sinking into the ground for that imprint. Good. Now we're going to do that bicycle, my bicycle, that we do in my class. We're going to take the right leg down, slide it up your mat. As the other leg extends, you reach your right foot high. So left leg, pull it in across the floor. Switch. 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 Really try to slide across the ground if you can. I know that I'm taking my mat with me. Slide it in. Slide it in. Now let's reverse it. Slide it forward to lift. Bend it down. Slide it forward to lift. Forward to lift. You got it. Almost. Four. Three. Push through the ground. Last one. Hug your legs. Woo. Good. Lovely. Let's bring yourself back up. Let's work on some planks today. So, we're going to do a little plank series. We're going to do full planks. You're welcome to be on your elbows, okay? But we're going to roll to one side, back to center, to the other side, center. And you can't move until I say. So you don't know how long that is. It's just what I say, okay? So if you're on your elbows, think I dream a genie. Stretching those legs out. Here we go. First plank, chest forward, shoulders back. Good, keep those hips lifted, don't let them sag. Pull that belly in, tighten those suspenders. Good, over to one side. Lift that arm high, be on the inside of one foot, the outside of the other. Keep your hips lifting away from the mat. Good, back to center, holding center. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Pull that chest forward. Think of the crown of your head going forward, your heels going backward. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Good, other side, roll it over. Holding, holding, holding. Breathe, keep those hips high, rolling those shoulders back. Good, back to center, hold. In the center, soften the knees, stretch. Knees, stretch, don't lose your bum. Keep it up there. Eight, seven, how we doing? Six, five, four, three, two, one. Lower those knees. Good work, child's pose. Take a moment. Good. We're gonna go into some back extension work, okay? Take a moment, let your head hang. Good. Down onto our belly. Back it up so you can see. Okay. So I call the football goal posts, right? Hands are to the side, bent at 90 degrees, which means they're not on your mat, okay? Let's bring those legs close together as you can to work those inner thighs, tucking that tail. Forehead down, roll your shoulders back to bring your chest and your eyes forward. So I just want you to lift your face up. I'm looking at the center of my mat right between my thumbs. Okay, so just enough, really about a fist and a half away from the ground. That's how high my forehead is, okay? Rolling those shoulders back, we're just gonna rotator cuff. Take your hands off the ground and lower. Lift, lower. Now, can you tuck your pelvis? Feel your pelvis push into the ground a little more so that you don't feel top heavy, right? There's a lot of work going on here at the upper part of our body in those shoulders, and we tend to kind of tip forward. So push your bum into the ground and keep your chest high. Find that rotation in the shoulder socket. Four. Two more. Good, last one. You gotta hold this rotation. Keep your hands in line with your temples. So your hands are higher than your elbows. And now exhale, lift your belly, lift your ribs, lift your elbows. Bring it down on the inhale, keep the hands high. Lift and lower. lift, and lower. Again, don't go so high. Think of going forward to come up. I want this lower back to stay long, not compressed, right? I want all the work in this rotator cuff, in between the shoulder blades and your thoracic extensors. Feel that belly pulled in to support your spine. 3, 2, 1 more. Good, down. You get to drop the knee to rest. We're gonna take this into a breaststroke, right? So from swimming, we're gonna bring ourselves up, circle those arms around, bring them up your body to your forehead and lower. So you gotta inhale when you come out of the water. So inhale and around and lower. Inhale and around and lower. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Tuck that tail, press your pelvis into the mat. 3, 2, 1 more. And down. Ooh, take a rest. You should feel that between your shoulder blades. Good. Nice. Now, let's try to lift up out of our hips. So let's come into our Sphinx position. Forearms parallel to one another underneath your shoulder. So elbows under the shoulders, shoulders rolled back. We're gonna tuck your tail, draw your belly in and up away from the ground, and pull your chest, the pendant of your necklace, pull it forward and up. So the crown of your head lifts to the ceiling and relax. Same thing, big breath. Tuck the tail, draw the belly in and up. Lift, lift, lift. And rest. Again. And lifting. And down. I want you to really try to find space between each vertebrae. So think there's an inch between each vertebrae. So you're growing very, very tall. You're trying to reach an extra foot, 12 inches higher to the ceiling. And down. Last one. Lift, 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 lift. And down. Good. From here, let's bring it back down. One hand on top of the other. We're going to take this into your legs. I'm going to move forward so you can see more of my legs. My face is important here. So, tucking the tail, stretch your legs so they hover. Forehead is down. Okay? And we're just going to flutter kick up and down, up and down. Then you squeeze your glutes. Feel that squeeze around your sit bones. Feel that pelvis tucking down into the ground, that belly button lifting. Breathing, breathing. Try to relax the shoulders. Pull them away. 5, 4, 3, 2. Can you squeeze your legs together? Take them higher and down and higher and down. As those legs go higher, think of tucking the tail, scooping your belly in and up. So trying to flex your lumbar spine, which is the opposite of what it does naturally, the opposite of what you're trying to do here with your legs, right? You're extending with your legs. Try to flex that low back. So all the work comes from your hamstring and your glutes, right? It's really the bottom of that glute max there. That's what's gonna give you that nice little lift in the glutes, that definition in the hamstring. 3, 2, 1, down, rest. Good stuff. Let's push it back to a child's pose again. Let's curl our toes underneath us this time and push our hips back, come forward. Push back, forward. It's a nice big stretch of that hamstring. It also sinks those thigh bones back into the sockets. 4, 3, 2, 1 more. Good, we're gonna come to our side. We're gonna do some more oblique exercises here. So let's have those legs bent. Top hand beside your head. And we're just gonna drop the chin down and lift. Lift and lift. 4, draw that waistline in. Good, now take the top leg out. And we're gonna pull the leg in. As the body lifts, you can just focus on the leg if you prefer, right? If you're feeling this too much in your neck, drop that chin, drop your eyes, and think of your armpit lifting so you get more elbow to knee. 4,
three, two, one. Bring the head down. Let's take both legs long and go into that oblique lift. So again, fighting for that left handle. Both legs up, down, up. So a little bit lower, really right in that little meat just above the waist of your pants, just above your hip bone. Breathe. Almost. Five, four, two, one. Good. Bring it in. Push it up. Let's go for the other side. Alright, so we started with those legs bent. Top hand behind the head. We dropped the chin just to protect, so we're not lifting the neck. Right? The head is coming along with our ribs. Take it up. Up. Draw that belly in. Three. Two. Go over and take the top leg. Join it. Reach them. Try not to push with that left hand. You will push a little bit with the elbow. So turn your palm up so you're not pushing with your hand so much. Fight on that oblique, pulling together. Three, two, one. Good, bring it down. Both legs long. We lift them up, down, up, up, up. You got this. Eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring it down. Good. Push yourself up.
Grab yourself some water. We're going to do a nice big stretch today. I think Mother's Day deserves a big stretch. Okay? Okay, let's come down onto our back. Let's do a really good leg stretch today. So laying on our back, let's pull that right leg in. Grab the back of your thigh and push that heel high. Good, bend the knee to the chest. Push it out. Bend. And push. I want a little resistance. Use your hands to pull down. Push your heel up. Bend it down. Push back up. So your hands don't want to bend your knee. Right? Two. Can we hold it high? Point the toes, flex. Point, flex. Stretch as much as you can behind that knee, right? So that's why I don't hold here. If my leg's totally bending, my bum is lifting. Just keep your bum on the ground. Ankle circles. Circle the other way. Good. Bend the knee down, slide the left leg out if you haven't. Just place the left hand on and spiral, reach it over. As far as you're comfortable, reach that big toe to the floor, let your knee follow it as best that you can, right? It's not to match me, it's as best that you can. Right arm is trying to stay connected to the floor. So you're breathing into the right side of your body. Good, and then come back to center. Just do a little tiny bridge. Just recenter your spine. Good. Same leg, right foot, cross the ankle over. Reach through, let's stretch out that bum. I said we'd stretch it out because we worked it hard today in the beginning of class. And again, we touched on it at the end, so we focused on those glutes a lot. In your stretch, focus on the length of your spine. Feel your lower back, your pelvis dropping, your sit bones reaching for the bottom of your mat, down to the wall in front of you. Try to drop your chin so you're not arching through the neck. Take your right hand out, slide your right knee across so your knees are now on top of each other.
So my right hand grabs my left grabs my right, and I just hug them a little closer. So that just moves the stretch a little more to the outside of that right glute rather than so centered. Good. Go ahead, we'll let it go. Good, again, just a little bridge. Good, we'll pull the left leg and we'll start with that hamstring. So stretch the leg high, flexing the foot. Use those arms as the leg resists to come in. Use the leg as you resist with your arms to push down and push. And again, keep trying to keep your glutes, your bum cheeks, your jean pockets, if you will, flat on the mat. So you keep that length in the lower back. You're trying to keep your pelvis down, right? And just focus on the hamstring rather than the back so much. Hold the leg straight. Straight, straight, straight. Stretch through the knee. Point and flex. Point and flex. Circle the ankle. Just breathe. Let that air come in, the air go out. Go ahead, circle the other direction. Good. Let's pull the knee into the chest. Slide the right leg long. Good. We're going into that spinal up and over. Good. So again, your toes reaching for the floor. Your knee is following that toe. Left arm is trying to stay connected, so you're breathing. Focus that air into the back of your ribs, right? Really feel that left lung expand. And then you'll notice how tight you are in the rib cage. Yeah, let's open that up. We hold a lot of tension there. We don't take enough deep breaths during our regular days. Especially if we're dealing with a lot of things, we get more stress and tension. Our breaths will become shorter. Let's take this time to open it up, to allow that breath to be bigger. Good, releasing it. Again, both knees are bent to push into a little bridge, and then we go into that ankle, cross the leg over. Oh, this guy's tight. Take your time to settle in. Try to drop the chin so the back of the neck is long. Try to use your biceps to support your legs here. To open up the collarbone and relax the shoulders. And take big, big, deep breaths. Focus them all the way down to where you're feeling that tension. Where you feel most restricted. Think of it as you breathe, you can blow that dark cloud away. Right? You can blow that tension away. Go ahead, take the left hand out, slide your knees together. And keep pulling those legs in tight toward your belly, toward your chest, keeping your bum down. Place both feet down, push up through a little bridge, and down. Good, rolling over, coming to your hands and knees. And let's just finish with a little hip flexor stretch, so you can always pat up your knee more, but bring your left leg forward. Feel those hips sinking. Go and let it go. Change legs. And again, every time you do a thigh stretch or your kneeling lunge like this, you can hold it way longer than I am today. Just feel those hips sinking down. Okay? Feel those hips dropping. Go and let it go. Bring your feet back behind you. Curl those toes to push yourself up onto your feet, lifting your bum. I just want you to hang upside down for a moment. You want to hold your elbows. All right, give yourself a little wiggle here. Then find some stillness, dropping your chin. Take a big breath. Roll it up.
Drop your tail, scoop your belly. Lift, 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 lift. Go ahead, shoulder rolls. Go ahead, big breath to finish. Inhale. And out. One more time. Inhale. And out. Go ahead, shake out your arms. Shake out your legs. You guys are all done. Go enjoy Mother's Day. Do anything special that you got planned for your mothers or your kids got planned for you. All right?